Welcome back to Sruthi Lakshmi's virtual classroom. Today we're going to be looking at the box method division, which is a very easy way of doing your division problem without miscalculating. Let's see the first example, which is 552 divided by 3. Here, 552 is our dividend and 3 is our divisor. Next, we draw a rectangle like this and split it into 3 sections. Why 3 sections? Because our dividend here has 3 digits. Now, we write each of these 3 digits into one of these sections like this. 5, 5 and 2. Next, we write our divisor outside the box like this. Now, let's look at the steps. These steps are very similar to the normal long division. But instead of bringing down, we bring up. So let's start. Now we see how many 3s can fit in 5. 1 3 can fit in 5. So we write 1 over here. So now we multiply 3 times 1. 3 times 1 is 3. Next we subtract 5 and 3. 5 minus 3 is 8. Now we bring up this 2 over here. So 25. How many 3s can fit in 25? 8 3s can fit in 25. So 8 times 3 is 24. 25 minus 24 is 1. Now we bring up this 1 over here and continue this process. So 3 times 4 is 12. 12 minus 12 is 0. Since we have a 0 here, we can ignore all of these numbers. Now let's look at the top numbers, which are our quotient. So our quotient is 184. So the answer is 184. And we have a remainder of 0. See how organize this division problem looks and how easily we calculated our answer without any difficulties. Now let's take a look at another example, which is 825 divided by 8. Here 825 is the dividend and 8 is the divisor. So we're going to write 8, 2 and 5 like this and write the divisor 8 outside the rectangle. Now, we are going to divide. How many 8s can fit in 8? Well, 1 8 can fit in 8. So, we write 1 over here and multiply 1 times 8, which is 8. So, we are going to subtract 8 minus 8, which is 0. Since we have a 0 here, we don't have to bring it up since it doesn't change the value of 2. Now we're going to repeat these steps until we reach the last digit. So now, how many 8s can fit in 2? Well, 0 8s can fit in 2. So 8 times 0 is 0 and 2 minus 0 is 2. Now we're going to bring this 2 up over here. So 25. How many 8s can fit in 25? 3 8s can fit in 25. So 8 times 3 is 24. Now let's subtract. 25 minus 24 is 1. Now, instead of a 0 like the last equation, we have a 1 here. So that means this number is our remainder. And the top numbers 103 are our quotient. So the answer to this problem is quotient 103, remainder 1. So now we are just going to ignore these two numbers. Now, let's see one final example, which is 428 divided by 6. Here, 428 is our dividend and 6 is our divisor. So, let's write 4, 2, 8 and 6 outside the rectangle like this. Now, we're going to divide. So, how many 6s can fit in 4? Well, 0. So, we're going to write 0 over here. 6 times 0 is obviously 0, so 4 minus 0 is 4. And next, we bring up the 4 over here, so 42. Next, we see how many 6s can fit in 42. Well, 7 sixes can fit in 42. So 6 times 7 is 42. So 42 minus 42 is 0. Since we have a 0 here, we don't have to bring it up. How many sixes can fit in 8? 1 6 can fit in 8. So we write 1. 6 times 1 is 6. So 8 minus 6 is 2. So our quotient here is 71 and our remainder is 2. Hope you like this video. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe to my channel and remember to hit the bell button. Bye! Thanks for watching!